It is the 12th day of the 12 days of DIY, and today for the final DIY, we are going to make a beautiful classic dessert that is for sure going to wow your guests this year. Nothing says Christmas like chocolate and orange, so today I'm going to show you my very favorite recipe for Clementine Granita, and we're going to serve it in homemade chocolate bowls. Okay, let's talk about what we need for this tutorial. You need 5 or 6 medium-sized clementines. We're going to be using some of that rosemary syrup we made on day 3, semi-sweet chocolate for the bowls, balloons to make the mold. You need something to cut and juice the oranges, 2 pots to act as a double boiler to melt the chocolate, and last but not least, we need a freezer-safe pan to make the granita. Now, when you get finished juicing your oranges, they don't need to be strained. It's great to have all of this pulp in there for texture, but if you have any giant pieces of pulp, you can take those out, and likewise, if you find any seeds, take those out too. Okay, so once your simple syrup and juiced oranges are stirred and all combined, this is ready to go in the freezer. It's going to be in the freezer for 2 hours, and we need to take it out every half an hour and give it a stir to break up the crystals. Like, this is why I love granita. It is so easy. You can make this the day of your dinner. It takes you no time at all, and it looks phenomenal. I guarantee you, people are going to say, "Oh my God, did you make that?" And you're going to say, "Yes, I did." And you're going to know that it was one of the easiest things that you've ever done, but they don't need to know that because you're going to look amazing. Okay, well, the granita is in the freezer setting. We can go on now and make the chocolate bowls. Okay, first things first, we need to melt our chocolate. So we're going to do the same thing we did for the white chocolate bark recipe, and we're using 2 pots because we're not so fancy that we have a double boiler at home. This will act like a double boiler. Hey, the chocolate is melting beautifully in our makeshift double boiler. Okay, your balloons are going to be about the size of grapefruits. And once the chocolate is melted and smooth, we just need to dip the balloons in the chocolate. Once your balloons have a really nice coating of chocolate around the bottom, we can pop them in the fridge set, and we'll take them back out when the granita's ready. Look, it's coming along. Pieces of ice are forming, so we need to just keep breaking it up every half an hour, and then back in the freezer. Look at our chocolate bowls, guys. They look so good. I just put a little tiny snip in the top of the balloon and let the air out, and gently peeled the bottom part of it off of the chocolate, and now we are left with these amazing chocolate bowls, just waiting for the granita. So once your granita is fully set and hardened, you just want to take a spoon and rake it over to create these little shavings of ice, and then it's ready for the chocolate bowl. Here is the final result. Doesn't that look so amazing? And guys, it is so delicious. The Clementine Granita is so tangy. It's such a wonderful palate cleanser and a great change from all of the heavy foods that we're eating at Christmas. And not to mention that beautiful chocolate bowl, your guests for sure are going to be wowed that you made this all by hand. So that is it for the 12 days of DIY, guys. I hope that you loved it. I had so much fun making this series. If you liked it, please leave me a comment below and let me know what you thought. And otherwise, I wish you all the very happiest of holiday seasons. Bye.